Please welcome Michael J.
Hey, hey. So you guys ready for some fun, right? I'm telling you something. I work at a lot of radio stations, and this is one of the coolest experiences because you're so close to the artist. And you get to get pictures today and that sort of thing. Couple of things we're talking about, rules, though. There won't be any selfies. They're asking for group pictures only. You'll be able to download those shots after the show. But we want to thank a couple of sponsors, then we're going to get started. I would like to thank sponsor Hungry Catering, taking care of the food. So tryhungry.com. Let's hear it for Hungry. And I can't see very well because these lights, but I'm told that M&T Bank is here somewhere. Where's the M&T Bank? So here's the thing. I want you to know at M&T Bank, I have been a customer of your bank since day one in Baltimore. Now, I know you guys go back to Buffalo and all that, but here's what happened. I live in a little neighborhood, and there's a bank at the end of the street, and it used to be called First National Bank of Maryland. Well, so I bank with them, and then they were bought out by AllFirst, or changed their name to AllFirst. So I stayed with them because they're right down the street. Then you guys bought them, so now I'm with M&T. And M&T has made a major commitment up in Baltimore. As you know, they have M&T Bank Stadium, which I think is awesome. You guys, now if we could just get Lamar Jackson to throw a tighter spiral, if you could help. Can you help with that? I love M&T Bank Stadium anyway. But thank you to M&T Bank for being here. We're going to have a little kind of conversation after they perform. And if you've got any questions, I'll look for you. And I'd be happy to introduce to you, you know, the guys and girls when they get up on stage. But I'd like to bring them out right now if we could. 30 Tigers recording artist, Gone West, featuring Colbie Caillat, have made their way here today. After spending, I guess, a week or so in the area, they played the Capitol 4th. Did anybody see them when they performed in D.C.?
Thanks for watching.
Yeah. Well, they did a great job. Lee Bryce was there, and of course, you guys. So I'm going to get out of the way. You guys perform. We'll be back to do a little conversation after you're done.
Cool. Thank you. Hi. Hello, everyone. How you doing? Thank you for spending part of your day with us. We're happy to be here. And this is such a great setup, too. We really appreciate it. So we're Gone West, and I want to explain a little bit about who we are and how we came together as a band. This is Justin Kavika Young right
Hello.
Here. This is Nellie Joy.
Hello.
And that is Jason Reeves.
Good morning.
So back in 2005, Jason moved from Iowa to Southern California, where I'm from, and we wrote a bunch of songs together, and all of those songs went on my first album, Coco. And we recently met Justin right after that.
Recently?
So I meant,
like
okay,
13
soon,
years ago. Yeah.
Soon after that, we met this guy. And I was a fan of his music in Hawaii, and I asked if he would join my band and sing and play guitar. So he joined, and then we got to tour the world together for about 2.5 years. Then we fell in love, and we've been together for almost 10 years now. And thank you very much. So the same year that we started dating in 2009, Nellie and Jason met in Nashville.
You guys don't even know
don't
if it's a happy
know.
Ending. I'm just saying. Or maybe you do. Okay, well, anyway, I've been in Nashville 14 years. I got my start there in a band called the Jane Deere Girls. And Jason came out to write with us, and it was love at first right. For Jason.
Don't believe her. It's not true.
And now we've been married 7.5 years.
So it makes it extra special that we're all friends and we're two couples. And it's cool because we all met friends first, working together, and then fell in love. So working together is what we've always known. And a couple years ago, we thought we should just try starting a band. And here we are.
For our first song today, we're going to play the song that explains the name of our band, Gone West. We all currently live in Nashville, but we're from west of there, Hawaii, California, Texas, and Iowa. So when we're not in Nashville, we've usually gone back home or gone west. And we write all our songs together, but this one was a little different because we split up and wrote each verse that we sing for our significant other about going to their hometown and bringing back the best that it has to offer back to Nashville. So this is Gone West by Gone West.
Headed out to California, gone west to see.
see the sun. There's a fortune here if you got time, but I found mine buried in the golden hair she spun.
Sugar cane, baby. I've gone west, rolling down the highway like a tumbleweed. I've gone west, where the canyons fall into the deep blue sea. Took a left from the hills of Tennessee. Yeah, I've gone west to bring the best back with me. I've gone west to bring the best back with me.
I chase the lights. The wild horses run.
Ooh.
I caught a painted angel moon rise, trying to spit fire like a bullet from a smoking gun.
Ooh. Going back to mama's home, playing in the field of dreams.
Ooh.
Yeah, I was looking where the corn grows and the skies glow, and I found your beauty.
Rolling down the highway like a tumbleweed. I've gone west, where the canyons fall into the deep blue sea. Took a left from the hills of Tennessee. Yeah, I've gone west to bring the best back with me. I've gone west to bring the best back with me. I've gone west, where the canyons fall into the deep blue sea. Took a left from the hills of Tennessee. Yeah, I've gone west to bring the best back with me. I've gone west to bring the best back with me.
Thank you.
Y'all are awesome. So even though we are two happy couples, we actually really love and prefer writing heartbreak songs. I know it's weird, but this is one of my favorites because it's a celebratory breakup song. Because honestly, have you ever been with someone and then they broke up with you and it was just so terrible that you just want to throw a party the minute it's over? Has that ever happened to anyone? Just me? Okay, cool. You! Good. Anyways, so yes, this song, if you're going through this, this goes out to you. Or if you've gone through it. Honestly, if someone doesn't want to be with you, you should throw a party. And if they decide to walk out that door, the only thing that should be hitting the floor isn't your tears, it's confetti.
We can't unsay.
Ooh.
Through the blinds I watch you speed away.
Ooh.
It might sound crazy, but I never thought it feels so good. Saying goodbye wouldn't stop you even if I could.
Yeah, my heart didn't break when I broke into that old bottle of fancy champagne. I've been saving the perfect time. You can't rain on my parade. Got my freedom, gonna celebrate. When you left, I was so damn ready. No tears fell, just confetti. Ooh, 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 ooh. Just confetti. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
I see you now.
Ooh.
You come home and kick the party out.
Ooh.
It's like my dreams to turn the music down. Now I'm singing loud and I never thought it sounds so good. Saying goodbye even better than I thought it would. Yeah, my heart didn't break when I broke into that old bottle of fancy champagne. I've been saving for the perfect time. You can't rain on my parade. Got my freedom, gonna celebrate. When you left, I was so damn ready. No tears fell, just confetti. I, ooh, 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 just confetti. I, ooh, ooh, ooh. The minute you walked out the door, there was a rainbow all over the floor. It's like Mardi Gras under my roof. Don't need a mop, I'm using a broom. Into that old bottle of fancy champagne. Been saving for the perfect time. Been rain on my parade. Got my freedom, gonna celebrate. When you left, I was so damn ready. No tears fell, just confetti. I, so damn pretty. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Thank you so much, you guys. So that song's off of our EP, Tides. We released an EP about, it was in January, and there's four songs on it. And we named the EP and soon-to-be album Tides because of all the highs and lows that we all go through in life and love. And it's what we were all experiencing the past couple years when we made that. Well, we made all these songs. So right now, we're actually going to do one of my old songs for you guys, if you're cool with that. Jason and I wrote this back in, I think, 2006? 2005?
2005 or 6.
There you go. And it's kind of funny because his roommate at the time had a crush on me, and Jason's perspective of the song is that I need to realize that me and that guy would be perfect for each other. And I eventually did. And then we dated for a kind of a couple years, actually. So, actually, we're not allowed to play any songs that aren't about him. So, I was just telling you the story. We're not going to play
here's
the
there goes
song.
The whole set, y'all.
But here's the super trick.
Fortunately, she realized some other things shortly after that. And so, we're all good.
No, the actual story is, nobody knows this. I'll reveal it now. I wrote that song about Justin. I write every song that I write about Justin.
It's true.
I mean, I just assume that anyway.
Our band is breaking up in real time. This is awesome. Just kidding.
Here's Realize.
Side. just realized we'd be perfect for each other. We'd never find another. Just realize what I just realized. We'd never have to wonder if we missed out on each other, but it's not the same. I know it's never the same. If you don't feel me too. Just realize what I just realized. We'd be perfect for each other. We'd never find another. Just realize what I just realized. We'd never have to wonder. Just realize what I just realized. If you just realize what I just realized.
Thank you. You guys are so wonderful.
You guys have been awesome. Thank you for being here. Can we give 98.7 a big round of applause for having us out today?
In this rad space.
Jeff, I don't know where you are because it's really dark in here. But thank you for taking time, and it was nice to meet your wife, wherever she is, too. Sorry, it's so dark. I just see a bunch of eyeballs. And Ty and Corey and Michael, too. Thank you, guys.
Yeah, thank you so much for having us.
And the sound guy, Matt. Where are you at? Matt? Thanks, Matt.
Yep. Can't see anyone. So we have we started writing for this project almost exactly 2 years ago. We wrote our first song for the record. And we wrote our last one just like about 3 months ago. And we loved this song so much the second that we wrote it and recorded it. And then we started playing it for people, and the reaction we got was just something really special. So we ended up choosing the last song that we wrote to be our first single for the record. And our actual ad date is next week on July 15th. And it's really cool because we're playing on Live with Kelly and Ryan. So we're going to be performing TV performance next week in New York. And we're going to play that song for you guys right now. Oh, it's intense. This is What Could Have Been. I haven't stopped thinking about you. Has it really been this long? 2 years in an ocean between us, and I don't know where it all went wrong. I know I could have kissed you. Yeah, you could have followed through. Should have talked a little bit softer, but we meant every I love you.
I don't know what this is or what it is, but it feels like we've got unfinished business. As we left blood on the track, sweat on the sand, fire in the hills and pulling in the barrel. Words never said in a story that didn't end. Looks like you're on the bed and I'm on the bottom. Folded our hands with money on the table. Tried moving on, but I keep coming back again. To a could have been.
Couple more simple I'm sorry's, a little less trying to be right.
just before our love was out of reach. Could have been enough, could have saved us from this loneliness. We left blood on the track, sweat on the sack, fire in the hills, a bullet in the back. Words never said in a story that didn't end. Looks like you're on the minute, I'm on the ball. Folded our hands with money on the table. Tried moving on, but I keep coming back again to a coulda been, a coulda been. But it still feels like we've got unfinished business. Cause baby, we left blood on the track, sweat on the saddle, fire in the heels, a bullet in the barrel. Words never said in a story that didn't end. Whoa, looks like you're on the mend. I'm on the bottle, we folded our hands. Money on the table, tried moving on, but I keep coming back again. Oh, to it could have been. Oh, it could have been. Yeah, it could have been. Should have been. Do you still wonder? Still wonder what could have been?
What could have been?
Still wonder
what could have been? We left blood on the track, sweat on the saddle, fire in the hills, a bullet in the barrel. Words never said in a story that didn't end.
Thank you so much, you guys. So if you want to check out our tour dates, we're on tour right now, actually, on the East Coast. You can go to gonewestmusic.com. It has all of our info, music videos, all that. Oh, hello.
I'm amazed by when you put four voices together like that, how that's got to be, it's difficult, isn't it, to be like at the right.
Yeah, key? I mean, it is. It's challenging, but it's such a nice feeling when you get it right.
Like, can you sing just the end of that song just by your side? I'd like to hear, like, each one of you guys.
Oh,
like,
that's terrifying.
Can you do
we
it?
Left blood on the track, sweat on the saddle, fire in the heels, a bullet in the barrel. Words never said in a story that didn't end.
And then that's got to match what you do.
Yeah, so we all know our harmony. You want me to do it?
Yeah, do it. I love hearing you guys sing individually. I think it's awesome.
Because we left blood on the track, sweat on the saddle, fire in the hills, and bullet in the barrel. Words never said in a story that didn't end.
See, that it's all the and then so complimentary. Now let me.
Hey, I'm going to sing it with her because she has the high harmony. And
I know,
that
that's
the most torturous.
Just listen to this
thing.
One.
I actually can't do it on my own.
I bet. Well,
I promise you.
Can you do it together?
Yeah,
I just love hearing the harmonies, though. It's awesome.
Because we left blood on the track, sweat on the saddle, fire in the hills, and bullet in the barrel. Words never said in a story that didn't end.
I love country music. Can you? And what do you do down the end?
What do you do?
Jason, I want to hear. No,
he's
wanna hear,
octaving.
I want to hear Jason do his.
I was just mouth singing.
He just looks good.
<singing.
laughs>
No, he's got the bottom. Let's hear him.
Let's hear it.
Like, so we left blood on the track, sweat on the saddle, fire in the hills, a bullet in the barrel. Words never said in a story that didn't end.
Oh, I love that. So, you guys,
first
I mean,
time
I
we've ever done that.
I don't know how much you know about all these, but I want you to understand this is a group. But you guys have got backstories. I mean, you did sell a lot of records, 6 million albums or whatever, and you did backup with Taylor Swift and got started with Jason Mraz, and you have the Grammys. But I feel like this is like your focus in your life now. This is, I mean, it just sounds like you guys have been together forever.
Well, thank you. I mean,
it's only been a year.
Well,
I mean, you've been.
It's been a year since we've been playing shows, and you know, we're playing literally every single day and practicing so much. But we truly, me and Jason, I think our voices have been trained for 14 years to sing together. 13 years for me and him, 10 for them.
Wow.
And then I think 7 for all four of us together in different ways. So it's just, I think it's, I would hope that after all that time we could be decent.
How would you describe the difference between what makes a great pop song and a great country song? Is there a difference, or is it the same thing, or is it flavor?
Maybe we should ask Dan and Shay. They seem to be doing all of it.
Yeah, they do. But I mean, when you're writing, though,
now, right?
Is there a difference in your mind when you're writing a country song, or do you just try to write a great song?
See, we didn't set out to just to write country songs. We started writing, and it just it was so crazy because, well, we all love storytelling, and we love organic instruments, and we love harmonies. And so it really, truly is like the perfect, most natural fit.
That's country music, yeah. Right? You just described it.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
I think the color in the lyric is something that country music really has to offer that pop music doesn't.
Did you guys grow up listening to a lot of different things?
Totally.
I mean, what did you, like Colbie and
Yeah, so I grew up listening to classic rock like Fleetwood Mac and Eagles and all that, and then Lauryn Hill and Bob Marley and John Mayer. Those were like my main influences. I mean, everyone has similar ones, but then very different ones.
The Judds and the Beatles.
Yay. What about you?
Bob Dylan, James Taylor, Pink Floyd. I love all that stuff.
What's your favorite James Taylor song?
Oh, man.
I'm a huge JT fan.
That's not easy. I love Steamroller Blues.
Fire and Rain.
They're all really good.
Fire and Rain's good, but I like his version of You Got a Friend, too.
Yeah.
There's so many good James Taylor
there
songs.
There are. He's incredible. And what about, who did you grow up listening to?
I grew up on Hawaiian music and reggae and soul music, so, yeah.
That's cool.
Which is actually, it's interesting because traditional Hawaiian music sounds extremely similar to traditional country music, and the steel guitar actually came from Hawaii and got brought back to...
Yeah, it was kind of like the Don Ho days back.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, yeah. It's
so, now, when are you guys getting married? Have you announced the date yet?
Never.
It's just you're just going to be engaged forever.
Maybe.
Yeah.
We're good. We're happy.
That's cool.
We're gonna be cool.
Well, I just thought I'd get some advice. I know you guys all know each other, but I don't know. I mean, I just met you guys today. I don't know if Nellie and I don't know if you guys like gave them advice yet, or if you could after 7.5 years being married.
No, they should be giving us advice. They've been together longer than we have.
Yeah, actually.
But and marriage changes things, though. I'm telling you, when you put a ring on it, right?
I don't know, because I didn't even really want a ring. But I guess the paperwork makes it a little complicated.
Okay, I'll take that.
Go ahead.
I'll take it. I just don't think there's any way we could give them any advice whatsoever. I think they're as married as we are.
Yeah.
It's just,
maybe more.
There is no ring on it, but a ring is just a ring.
Right.
You know what I mean?
All right.
We're like Oprah and Stedman. You know what I'm saying?
Right. Nothing wrong with that. So the new album, you mentioned you've got the EP out. Mm-hmm. When does that come out?
The EP.
Was out, but the album I'm talking about.
Yes. The album, we're actually almost finished with it. When we get back off a tour in August, we have like 10% left to just finish on production. We don't know when it's coming out, though. We're focusing on the first single right now.
Cool. Well, that's awesome.
Yeah.
And so Monday, you're in New York City, first time with Kelly, and now she's with a guy that we know because he works in iHeartRadio, and you know him from New Year's Eve. And is there any show between him and who's the other guy that does... Family Feud. I can never think of that guy's
Drew
name.
Carey?
No.
Oh, Steve Harvey.
Steve Harvey. He's like, those are the only two guys on television. Have you noticed they've got every TV show? But Ryan and Kelly, so that's going to be pretty cool. That's live television, right?
Yeah, I mean, we love them. Kelly's had us on her show so many times, honestly, over the years. And actually, when we did the tour for my album, The Malibu Sessions, the four of us were on her show singing one of the songs from the record. So, I mean, that was a few years ago. So it's always, live TV is always scary, but we're excited. Yeah.
And if you didn't see them on the 4th of July, you played the big festival in Washington. You've also played the White House, I guess, a couple of times, right?
Yeah, we did the Easter egg roll when Obama was in office.
That's
and
cool.
Was literally the coolest thing. We were on the White House balcony with the first family.
Wow.
It was incredible.
That's sweet. One more time, let's hear it for Gone West.
Thanks, you guys.